second meeting. In four nights, Calgary 4-1 winners on Thursday at the Saddledome. Ritchie dumps it out of Vancouver's own. Chatfield leaves for Yalevi. Ahead to Gadzovich. Dangerous pass. Josh Levo in. He scores. The rookie turned it over at the blue line. And Josh Levo moved in with a deke to the backhand to make it 1-0 Calgary.
Here's the play. You can see Gadzovich is just going up the middle, but instead of, he's a foot from the blue line. Get it out. Gadzovich tries to get a little too cute. Trying to hit Jimmy Vesey, and Josh Levo is right there. Settles it down.
McEwen moves in wide. Puck knocked away from him. Milan Lucic skates back to center. Lucic ahead for Levo. He's got a step on the left wing. Put it in front. Lucic scores. Levo got around Ole Yalevi and was able to set it up front for Milan Lucic. The Vancouver native makes it 2-0 Calgary.
Ole Yalevi can't turn. You see Yalevi stumbles and it's off.
Gadzovich dropping the gloves with Connor Mackey. So Jonah Gadzovich in his NHL debut. Now we got another scrap breaking out with Simone and Chatfield potentially. But it's Mackey and Gadzovich in the main event. And Gadzovich right hand free after Mackey got his loose first.
Mackey had the short jabs going, and Gadzovich was waiting for the haymaker.
He's getting 2, 5, and 10. Got the instigator in this one. A little bit more about Gadzovich. You can see he's a big boy.
Boyd for Hoagland. It's rare that he doesn't take a pass with authority. And back comes Gaudreau. Puck sent in front. Kachuk with a shot. He wide to wide. Got his own rebound. He scores. Puck came hard off the end boards. And Kachuk was able to beat his check to it. Might have been Hoaglander to make it 3-0 Calgary.
Watch where the shot goes. And you can see Matthew Kachuk. He'll take the shot. And Chatfield is there. And he watches the puck and lets Kachuk go right by him. Now you take the man. Shot, take the man. And you can see Chatfield turns around to find the puck. Well, it's in the net. You see Chatfield's reaction. He realized.
Flames are moving up ice again. Mangiapane checked by Hamonic. Flames get the puck to Dubé. Checked by Pearson before he gets a shot away. Now they score as Mangiapane roofed that one from in tight. And the Flames are piling it on here in the second period.
Canucks played yesterday, but these are just mental errors, and you can see, okay, here's the bouncing puck. Both defensemen are watching the bouncing puck. Mangiapane on Travis Hamonic. They strip him of the puck, and there's Tanner Pearson and Quinn Hughes spinning around, and
we apologize if we're making this sound like it's the season finale. It kind of feels like it to us because it's the last game we're doing, but there are a couple more to come after this one. Here's Hamonic moving into the shot. He scores! Against his former team, Travis Hamonic pots his second of the season, and the Canucks are on the board.
This time he's on the wing, right-hand shot. Valimaki lets him go to the outside, and you can see Jacob Markstrom's reaction. This is a pretty good shot, just at that funny height. Just above the pad. See, Markstrom gets the right pad down.
Point for Quinn Hughes as he drew an assist on that one. There's a long shot, and it beat Holtby through the legs. Andrew Mangiapane has his second of the period. And the Flames are back up by 4.
Making Backlund. Oh, it's not. It's JT Miller, and it's Chatfield. Here's the shot. Mangiapane just slides back. Went through Backlund and Chatfield. And
40 seconds to go on the penalty to Michael Backlund. Hughes rushes in. Edler's gone to the bench. Pass across. Miller for Graham. And he scores. Set up from JT Miller has the second Canuck goal of the game, and Vancouver's 1-for-2 on the power play.
Here's Quinn Hughes. Go wide, go wide. Valimaki, what's he do? Can't chase him. And as soon as he does chase him, that opens it up. Hughes makes that long pass, beautiful pass. And Miller gets a little break, tip, and goes right to Grayovac.
Alex Edler at the line. Quinn Hughes. Edler takes a look, lets it go off a stick, kick back to Hughes, across, Besser scores! Canucks are 2-for-3 on the power play. Hughes has 3 assists as Brock Besser makes it 5-3.
Besser had that other chance in tight and Jacob Markstrom just stayed with him, but this time, Jacob Markstrom has to move across, so he has to open up, and Besser goes back the other way. Goes right through Chris Tanev, and then
Jimmy Vesey moving in shorthanded. Vesey, Miller, trying to get it back to Vesey, and sprawling to break it up was Giordano. Now Vesey, Miller scores! Canucks, 2 on the power play, and now 1 shorthanded for J.G. Miller, and it's a 1-goal game.
Inside the hash marks. Easy to Miller. They tried to get too cute, but the Flames don't clear it. What a play by Jimmy Vesey and Markstrom and Jerry.
Gains control, carries to the corner, spins there. Fires back. Edler with a shot. Knocked down by the glove of Markstrom, who was then bumped. Couldn't squeeze it. Miller has the puck. Edler shoots. He scores!
J.T. Miller with a nice play, and this one's knocked down by Jacob Markstrom, and Miller just cruising in the middle, feeds it back.
Puck thrown up the middle, knifed into the Vancouver zone, Hamonic takes a look, drives it around, gets it out, and that's going to do it. Canucks score 4 in the third, 2 from Besser. Gaudreau wide on Highmore, cutting it on Roll, gets around Edler, tees it up at the side, and Valimaki couldn't get it on net. Here's Lindholm. Centering pass deflected in. Went in off a Canuck stick, I believe. Edler and Boyd were there, but I think it was Alex Edler who put his stick on that one. And Lindholm able to ricochet the puck past Braden Holtby.
Flames had those quick goals. Here's the chance, and I thought Valimaki was going to put that one away. And here comes Alex Edler out in front, and he gets a piece of it. And you can see Edler's reaction there, trying to feed it across to Johnny Gaudreau, Lindholm, and Alex Edler just off the toe of his stick and into the corner behind Braden Holtby.